and welcome to theCUBE's Tech Innovation Cubed Awards, where we are celebrating the winners of our inaugural program, and we're celebrating the incredible ingenuity, creativity, and innovation that's taking place all across the technology landscape. I'm Shelly Kramer, and today I'm joined by CUBE alum Manoj Saxena, who's the CEO of Trustwise, and he's a winner in theCUBE's Most Innovative Tech Startup Leaders category. And we're going to explore today how Manoj and his team are working to innovate and drive the industry forward. Manoj, this is not the first time I've had the pleasure of interviewing you, and I could not be more thrilled to see your success in this CUBE Awards category. I'll also note, before we dive in, that in addition to your recognition as an innovative tech startup leader, Trustwise's Optimize AI, which you and I have talked about before here on theCUBE, brought home the win in the most innovative AI products category. Congratulations. What an amazing set of accomplishments.
Well, thank you, Shelly. And it is great to see you. Always enjoy our conversations. I want to first start off by saying, you know, thank you to theCUBE and the panel of judges. The award, you know, it's never about one person. It's the entire team that has kind of enabled me to get to this point. So on behalf of both all the employees at Trustwise and the investors and customers, this is a huge shot in the arm for us. So thrilled to be winning those dual awards.
Absolutely, absolutely. Well, and I'm going to say that they are incredibly well-deserved. So Manoj, the thing that has always resonated with me the most about you is your passion for ethical and safe AI practices. And it is in no way an understatement to say that this is truly your life's work. I know that you've been referred to as the father of IBM Watson based on the many years you spent with IBM and your amazing accomplishments there. Will you indulge me just a moment and share with us a bit about your career backstory?
Sure, happy to. You know, I'm one of those blessed immigrant stories. You know, I came to the US about 35 years ago. I've built and sold a few companies, one of which was bought by IBM. And then I had the honor of being asked by the IBM board and CEO to run IBM Watson as the first CEO, first general manager of it. And about a year into it, an incident happened that literally put me, that changed the direction of my life and put me on this path. I was in Washington, D.C., talking about how we were putting Watson to work in cancer, and you know, about 8,000, 10,000 people in the room. And this gentleman starts me like within 10 minutes of my talk, right dead in my tracks, and says, I know what you're doing. My wife has a third stage breast cancer, and with Watson in cancer cure, you're building the Obama death panel machine. This machine will decide whether she's gonna live or die, and this machine can't explain itself as to how it took the decision it did. I mean, you talk about a moment that hits you in your face. And I was literally in tears driving down to the airport saying, my entire life, 20 plus years, all these companies I've built and sold, was built on this premise, this false premise of move fast and break things. That's what Silicon Valley was all about. And I realized, this is 10 years ago, that there's nothing like that that's gonna work with AI. This, there's nothing artificial about AI. This is gonna impact human beings, like this gentleman's wife and what he was concerned about. Right. So that's when I set on this journey and I created this nonprofit called the Responsible AI Institute 9 years ago, almost like an independent verification company, because each of these companies are gonna grade their own homework and right, say, I've got the best AI. So I said, we need a nonprofit, almost like an underwriter's lab so your toaster doesn't kill you, right? So we've created the Responsible AI Institute. And then I was teaching responsible AI at the University of Texas, Austin, and down in Cambridge in England when ChatGPT got launched. And that's when I realized how fast this technology has moved. And I also realized how exponential this is going to continue to grow. And everyone was focused on building the engine, the nuclear core. No one was looking at how do I build the dome, the safety control systems for these, right, if it's out of control. So that has brought me to starting Trustwise again as my fourth startup. You could call me a certified masochist for being a CEO four times around, but it's awards like this and recognition from customers that keeps us driving. And I fundamentally believe we are working on the most important problem in AI today, which is how do you unlock the potential of these AI systems safely for both companies and society? We have an 82% failure rate of AI projects not getting into production because people are scared. And the market, the approach, and the policies now being pulled aside, it's almost like with recently with EU and the US administration throwing the policies out of the window. Basically, it's like asking people, and we have already done this, we're jumping out of the airplanes, with parachutes, and we're designing the parachutes as we are falling. That's literally how AI is being designed. So I get passionate about saying, these are things, that's my duty. This is not just an opportunity to build a company and make money. This is what technology should be used for, is to make technology safer. And that's sort of where, you know, Trustwise is, and that's what our mission is, to build this trust layer of AI so people can use that with confidence and people can use that with quality.
I love it. I love it. I'm a fan. And I will tell you that, you know, we all bring our own experiences and our biases into whatever it is we do. I spent my very, very early career days as a paralegal thinking I wanted to go on to law school and be a trial attorney. And I didn't end up going that path, but I started my first company when I was 34. And every step along the way, I am always risk aware. And I'm thinking about things like, you know, trust and security and building on a foundation of security and things like that. And I continually find myself butting up against the Silicon Valley mantra that exists even today, Manoj, of, you know, move that fast and break things, and that's the way forward. And I think that that can be a very dangerous strategy for consumers and users. And so protecting them, I think, is incredibly important. So let's talk a little bit about this passion of yours, this passion for making responsible AI adoption attainable for any size organization. And I know this is what's driving, you know, what you have created with Trustwise. So talk with me a little bit, if you would, about how you're embracing innovation to address that critical need for secure and trustworthy AI in enterprise applications.
Absolutely. Happy to. And, you know, I think it was a Google CEO who said it. He said, AI is as powerful and transformative to the humankind as fire and electricity was. And I think it's very true. But unlike fire and electricity, we haven't figured out a way to safely build systems to harness it. You know, fire was only useful when you could trust it in a lantern. Electricity was only useful when you had a grounded plug that won't short you when you use it. We don't have those trustworthy containers around AI. And that's what enterprises are looking for. And specifically, I'm doing my work at three levels. One is by starting a company that is building these real-time trust layer into every prompt. So if I am a bank or a healthcare company, how do I make sure that every prompt that I'm putting into the system is actually aligned with my intent and my goals as a company? Because today, LLMs are nothing but giant engines with no steering wheels, no safety belts, no emission control, and it doesn't tell you, you know, how it's going to behave. So getting it to a place where companies can steer the output of these prompts and these AIs. And agentic AI is going to make this problem a thousandfold more dangerous. So one we are doing is we are building this trust layer almost like a tool. We call it Trustwise as a tool. So, and if you had a time, I would have shown a demo. Like if you're in Claude, if you're in ChatGPT, you can actually tell Claude now or ChatGPT, score this response you gave me on trust. Tell me how safe you are. Tell me how aligned you are with my business policies. Tell me how much carbon that I just used in the prompt that I sent you. Tell me how much you're going to cost me over the next 5 years. So what we have done is we have in kind of line embedded Trustwise as a tool in all the models. So no matter what cloud you use, no matter what model you use, now in real time, you can invoke Trustwise almost like a spell checker you would do in a Word document. You can now use a trust checker for safety, alignment, cost, and carbon of your system. And that's what enterprises are looking for, is confidence that these systems are aligned with my internal policies and external regulations. That's the first thing. That's what Trustwise does. And I'm thrilled to say we grew, you know, we exceeded our numbers. We're going to grow about over 400% this year. And we're funded by Hitachi Ventures and Allstate Ventures and an incredible number of customers, you know, who are banks and healthcare companies and professional services companies who have become even yum brands, you know, Pizza Hut, Taco Bell, they're deploying us over 1,000 locations to do voice AI in KFC and Pizza Hut and Taco Bell. So these are the kinds of customers who are beginning to now safely and in a trustworthy manner deploy it. So that's the first piece, is a startup that's giving you trust as a service, as an API, right into your models. The second thing I'm doing is continuing the work with Responsible AI Institute. And now we have announced this about a month ago. We are massively shifting the direction of Responsible AI Institute. We're going to give out agents that will give you badges. So now we are actually going to have a human-led agent on Responsible AI. So if you say, if I'm, say, Schwab, I just met the CIO at lunch today, says, I want to verify my work. So can I send the output of some of my AI to a Responsible AI Institute, and they will safely and securely and in real time score and badge my work and send it back to me that I can display to say, here's all my agents, here's all my AI systems, and this is the trust score on all of them. And here's how much it aligns to NIST AI RMF. Here's how it aligns to EU AI Act. Here's how it aligns to OAuth security policies. So that's the second part, is a badging service that we're announcing. There are 10 different badges that we're announcing with the Responsible AI Institute. That gives you the external validation. I like to say that Trustwise lets you verify, and Responsible AI lets you, Trustwise lets you trust, and Responsible AI lets you verify. So you trust using our software, but you verify it using a third party. And to say, is this score compatible with what the standards say? So that's the second piece. And the third piece I continue to do is teach and have speaking arrangements where I can go in and talk to the world about how things are working. And particularly with agentic AI coming in, the problem is, you know, like I said, 100-fold bigger, 1,000-fold bigger. Because what is agentic AI? It's essentially an action layer on top of LLMs. But now the agents can start using tools, they can start logging into computers, they can start reflecting and making decisions. So all the issues of hallucinations, of data leakage, of carbon impact, all of they go exponentially bigger. So yes, those are the three layers in which I'm spending my time. Trustwise, Responsible AI Institute, and education and funding. Most of my wealth I have given to my foundation. So we invest in companies that start applying AI in a trustworthy manner.
I love it. I love the whole concept of trust as a service. I don't think that's something we've really seen before. And I think that's really cool.
Thank you. Thank you.
Yeah, absolutely. So Manoj, can you walk us through an example of how customers are using Trustwise to solve problems related to responsible and ethical AI that maybe weren't possible? I mean, you talked about the badging and the assessment capabilities. Any other examples you might be able to share with us?
Yeah, I'll give you a couple. So one of our partners is KPMG. They are reselling our product in the market. But before that, they said, you know, we want to become customer zero ourselves. We want to actually use this for KPMG tax and audit and make that system that we're doing more trustworthy. So they have 15,000 tax and audit professionals, and they have about 50,000 pages on how to do audit of different companies. And they came to us and said, you know, we would like this prompt that we generate to be a lot more faster and a lot more accurate and free from hallucinations, a lot lesser on hallucinations. So when we took on their systems, I'll just say that the response time that they were using to generate a prompt that was validated and evaluated was in the double-digit seconds. Okay. And they were seeing hallucinations in the answers, and their cost numbers were going up as more and more users were coming on. And they were worried about what the carbon footprint of these models are going to be. So within 2 months, we were able to take their workload and we were able to optimize it. And we reduced their total cost of ownership by 83%. We showed them another 30% hallucinations that they were not catching. We reduced their carbon by over 66%. And we reduced their latency down to a couple of seconds. Right? So this is one example that is allowing them now to unlock auditors being able to audit much faster, almost using like a chat GPT. Same thing in legal. You know, we could do this with the legal profession. If you're preparing for a case, it can make sure that it's not hallucinating and making up cases like AI has done before, where it's made up cases, it hallucinated. So that's one example. The second example is we're working with NHS England, the healthcare side. Mm-hmm. They want to use AI to start training medical students for diabetes. So they have these 700 guidelines on how treatment should be done for everything from COVID to cancer to liver surgery. And they want to use a chat GPT-like system to train these medical students. But clearly, they want to make sure that the output is aligned to the protocols, because London may have slightly different protocols than Wales would. So can the AI understand that the output based on the question, I have to give you a different answer? So there is no alignment, we help you align that. Second, they want to make sure that the hallucinations are not there. Third, they want to make sure that the carbon footprint is the smallest, and the, because they have a gap of over 300,000 workers in NHS England over the next 7 years. And they want to use AI to cut down on non-clinical things like office administration and all. So they're using us in two different ways. One, we are working right now with them on helping create a training GPT. We call it MedAssist GPT. So more students can be trained and more nurses can be trained faster, and they can use AI in a confident way with lower cost, lower carbon, lower hallucinations, and higher alignment. The second thing now we are starting to deploy is agents in the back office for hospitals. So how do I make sure, because 50% of the time that nurses and doctors spend is on onboarding patients and prescriptions and communications and all that stuff. So we are now beginning to work with them on putting agents in place that are trustworthy that can start automating these manual processes. I can go on and on. There is a bank example, and there is even Pizza Hut and how they're using it for voice ordering. But you know, I just want to stop. But there are many examples I can give you.
Oh, I love it. Well, I thank you so much for that. So Manoj, as we wrap this conversation, your mantra, which has always stuck with me since our first conversation, do good, have fun, and make good money, but never get that sequence confused. That mantra of yours is really all about culture. And will you share with us a little bit about the role that you see culture playing in success with AI, and about how you personally are fostering culture and creativity within Trustwise?
Well, absolutely. You know, culture is the operating system and the glue that makes us who we are as humans. That's what makes us accomplish things or not. And I can say this recently, and I was so delighted. I had the honor of speaking to American Express and hundreds of their lawyers and people internally. And the chief legal officer at American Express started off by saying, we have these blue box values of American Express that we use on all parts of the company, and our AI systems start with embodying those values. And I told them, this is so refreshing to see everyone start looking at AI, not as a technology, but as a way to implement and amplify your values. Yeah. So to me, I think that's step number one. There's a lot of companies doing that. American Express is one I recently found. But truly, the building a culture where AI is seen as augmented intelligence and not artificial intelligence. Yeah. Something that every knowledge worker will have their own Iron Man Jarvis suit. So we can now do a lot more things with AI. And that means to look at AI not as a technology and models and data, but as a way to deliver value to our customers and partners and work back on it. So culture starts with setting the tone around, this is about outputs, this is about human impact, this is about the values with which we deliver human impact. And in terms of Trustwise, I mean, to me, I've said this many times to the team, what is culture? Culture is nothing but, to me, it's only two things. It's beliefs and actions. What do we believe in, and do our actions line up with what we believe in? And we, every account, every customer, every product feature that we build, we ask the question, so what? And what does this mean to the end customer? Is it just because Manoj got up at 3 a.m., he's got a great idea for a feature? Or is it because he can connect the dots from this as to why this matters to the end customer? So I think as a team, we embody that in everything with respect to how we deal with customers, how we build products, what investors, we're in a great position with the number of investors who are interested in investing, but I've only raised $3 million and I'm almost cash flow break even. We are not looking to raise a whole lot of money at this stage, but our values are, we're talking to a lot of investors, and we will take money from those who embody these values and this thesis that AI is about doing good, having fun, and then making a lot of money in that sequence.
I love it. No fluff, no smoke and mirrors. Walking the walk, talking the talk. I think that is, you know, really resonates with, I'm sure, your customers and your team. So that's amazing. Manoj, congratulations to you and the whole team at Trustwise for the recognition that you've earned. I am so thrilled by your well-deserved success. To our audience, thank you so much for tuning into this special segment on theCUBE Tech Innovations Award. I'm Shelly Kramer. Stay tuned for more.